Welcome to FOMAS Solution. I'll be taking you through tutorials concerning car plugs. Now, let's get a brief introduction to car plugs. Car plugs, like any other mass area, deals with the study of changes occurring between situations in real life and motion. Also, what makes it interesting is that it considers algebra, geometry, trigonometry and other aspects of mathematics which are basic as its core standard. What makes it more interesting is that in calculus we introduce the idea of limits, differentiations and what? Integrations. So we starting with functions, since calculus deals with the explanation of a function with respect to its diagram or its nature. So let's revise a little bit about functions and relations. Okay, to begin with, let's talk about functions. From our previous lessons from Algebra 1, Algebra 2, and during our senior high secondary school, we taught functions. So here, functions are actually statements that assign elements in one set, let's say a domain, to other elements in another set, let's say the codomain, with specific rules. Also, when we talk about relations, relations deals with ordering pairs of what? Elements. For example, when we have X paired with Y, this is an illustration showing what relations, that means there is a relation between X and Y. Also, relations can go as further as forming what? Mappings. And on top of mappings, what comes in mind? Mapping only shows the relation between two sets, that's the elements in the domain to the elements in the codomain. So mappings can occur in form of what? Graphs, to show the relationship between two sets, let's say set X and set Y, with the X becomes the domain and the Y becomes the co-domain of the function. Now we have other functions that fall under calculus, which are also known as transcendental, transcendental functions. Now for transcendental functions, they are also functions that behave in different ways. They do not have a particular way in which they behave. So we'll be taking them one after the other to find how each of those transcendental functions occur in nature and the kind of behavior they have in nature. And we also be talking about circular functions. Circular functions under the transcendental functions. Now for the circular functions, we'll be talking about the trigonometry ratios, that the sine graphs, cos graphs and tan graphs, in addition to what? Circles as a whole. So these would be the graphs or relations or functions that we'll be considering under what? Transcendental functions, which fall under circular functions. Now let's see how to identify a graph of a relation, either it being a function or not. And also, how can we determine whether the graph is a one-to-one function? Because most of our functions that we'll be talking about must be what? One-to-one. Now, we have various ways to determine whether a graph of a function is a function or not a function. So, to determine a relation being a function, first, we use what we call the vertical line test. For the vertical line test, it helps us to identify a graph as a function or not. So we all know a vertical line is actually a line that runs from the top to down without any inclinations. So I'm going to put down two different graphs and we use this vertical line test to determine whether they are functions or not. Let's say this graph A, we have our Cartesian plane or axis, the y axis and the x axis, and the graph moves this way, that way, starting from this point and ending here. Also, let's take graph B, have our Cartesian plane, our y axis and our x axis, and we have the graph moving this way, that way. So let's say we have f of x here, we have another f of x, which is the name or the function to which these graphs assume. Now using the vertical line test, let's find out which one passes the test and which one fails to pass the test. When it passes the test, it's a function, fails to pass the test, it's not a function. So when the vertical line we are going to draw at any point we like, when it cuts the graph at only one side or intersect the graph once, it means the test has been passed. But when it cuts or intersects with the graph more than once, that means that graph will not form a what function. So let me draw any vertical line here. We can see that this vertical line intersects with our function at exactly one place or one point. So we can say this particular graph passed the vertical line test. Without doubt, I take another vertical line, you can see that it cuts the function, its graph at only one point. So this graph actually forms what? A function. Now let's come to graph B. We have another f of x, which its graph is being plotted or sketched here. Let's try to see whether it passes the vertical line test or not. Here, what happens? We can see that the vertical line intersects the graph at exactly two points or places. So this shows that this particular function is not a real function. It may be a relation, but not what? A function. Another vertical line shows that it cuts it more than once. So this type of graph is not a function, but when it cuts at only one particular part, we term it as what? A function. The last thing we have to do today is to find out whether a particular function is one-to-one or not. We have a test for that as well. For us to test whether a graph of function is one-to-one, we use what we call the horizontal line test. The horizontal line test. We know a horizontal line, a line that runs from the east to the west, or from the west to the east with no gradient. So that's a horizontal line. So what happened to the vertical line test, also when we draw the horizontal line across any graph and it casts the graph or intersects the graph once, it means that graph is a one-to-one function, but when it casts it more than once, it means that particular graph is not a graph of a one-to-one function. So let's have graph A here with our Cartesian plane, our x, y axis, sorry, and we have our x axis also here. Let's say we have this graph and extend the x axis a little bit. Okay, and let's say we have graph B. Which runs this way. Now let's test graph A, whether it will be a one-to-one function or not, using our horizontal line test. I draw a horizontal line here to cut across the graph of the function. What happens? You can see now the horizontal line cuts the graph at exactly more than one place. So we have two intersections here. We show that this graph is not a one-to-one function. Okay, it's not a one-to-one function. Now taking the second graph, that's graph B, and I draw a horizontal line here, you can see that it cuts the graph at exactly one point. When I draw another one, also exactly one point. Unlike this, when I draw another one here, we still have two of the points there. So since graph B has only one point intersecting with the horizontal line and the graph of the function, we can say this function is what? One-to-one function. So these are the two ways we can differentiate between whether a function exists in a graph or not, and here whether that function is one-to-one or not. So this is just a brief introductory aspect of calculus.